Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome back to another episode of The Real Lil Show. As always, I give my unique takes going on in the world of sports and entertainment. And man, oh man, do we got a fight that we got to recap tonight. Not that it was anything special, but it daggone was a fight and it was free. So you know what? I'm going to record and talk about it, you know? I always love them free fights, man. You know, it was hit or miss, but it is what it is. If I ain't got to spend money, I am balling. As I get a sip of this water, I don't know why the hell I need water so fast. We're only 37 seconds into the daggone show, but you know how it go. But either way, ladies and gentlemen, like and subscribe to the channel to start us off. You know, definitely like the video, subscribe to the channel. We got a lot of content that's going to be dropping soon in the near future. Definitely like, subscribe, and share this video at the end of the video so your friends or your family members can listen to some good content. You know, you always got to spread the word, brother. I know some people that don't like to share. They watch good movies and they don't tell nobody nothing. Right? We, you know, everything is a secret. Like the daggone Illuminati. It is what it is. Anyway, let's get right into it. I think I didn't ramble too much. But anyway, Adrien the Problem Broner made his return to the ring tonight against Jovanie Santiago from Puerto Rico, undefeated fighter. I believe had around 15 fights. And this was a fight that Adrien Broner said that he wanted to resurrect his career. Right? Me personally, I just think he did this fight just to stay out of jail because he got a case coming or whatever or something like that to that effect. He had a case that was lingering. So the brother was like, listen, I'm going to just try to look like a model citizen, so let me just get this bag. But I'm still questioning his love of the sport. I don't think it was displayed tonight. But, you know, I thought Santiago won the fight, if I'm being real. All three judges gave the fight to Broner. Broner won via unanimous decision. And I thought that the judges robbed Santiago, and I actually wanted Broner to win this fight because I do believe a motivated Broner is a good Broner. This was a guy that had talks of being the next Floyd Mayweather, and you know, Mayweather is always good for the sport of boxing because of the money that Mayweather obviously generated and brought into the daggone sport and changed the landscape of the sport. So Broner was supposed to be that guy that took the baton of Mayweather and be that next guy, but obviously, you know, it didn't work out, especially the fame, and the fame got to the brother, just like a lot of these other cats in other sports. You know, he wasn't the same. We saw the last fight against Pacquiao, but in this fight against Santiago, I thought that Broner picked it up a little bit late in the fight. Yeah, this is a guy that likes the party, and obviously he loves to come late to the party because he surely came late to the party in this fight. It took about 7 rounds for the guy to actually start jabbing. I thought that Santiago won rounds 1 through 6. I thought that he made a concerted effort to go to the body and get the body shots, because Broner's not a guy that protects himself from the body shots. As you know, he's too busy worried about the daggone face, or I gotta look good. So the body shots is open for the taking, and that's exactly what I thought they did in the first 6 rounds. And I thought that they stopped doing that later on in the fight. And in round 7, Broner caught the brother with a left hook, a left jab. And I'm surprised that, you know, Santiago didn't touch the ground. I thought that could have been a knockdown. Obviously, his knees didn't touch the ground, his arm didn't touch the ground. And I'm convinced that this brother be out here on Sundays, daggone Angelina, the daggone ballerina. I think he be doing ballet, to be honest with you, because there's no way that you keep your balance like that. So I don't know if the brother is, you know, doing ballet on the low, but brother, I don't know. I just don't know. But he should have went down. But I thought after that sequence right there, it showed Broner a little bit something. Broner was like, I actually could take this cat out of here. And he started jabbing a little bit more. I thought Santiago was doing more, but I thought that from round 7 through 11, which I all gave to Adrien Broner, which could have went either way, even though Santiago was throwing more, I didn't think he was landing as much. Well, not I think. He clearly wasn't landing as much as he was throwing. And I thought Adrien Broner, even though he threw less, he still was landing some of the more effective shots in that stretch. And that's why I gave that round to Broner. But if you was to give like the 10th or 11th to Santiago, I wouldn't have been mad, because those fights, those rounds were close. Those could have went either way. I just gave the round to Broner slightly. I don't know if I just gave it to him just to give it to him, because I was actually happy to see him jabbing a little bit more, because this is a guy that don't throw volume punches. He don't throw a lot of punches at all, so maybe I just gave him, you know, a point or two more just for the effort. And maybe that is true. Maybe that was me, you know, just like, oh, he jabbed, let me give him a point, let me give him this round, you know. It could have went like that, but obviously the judges agreed with me and they gave those rounds to Adrien Broner. But I thought where Santiago messed up was when he stopped coming forward. You know, this is a guy in Adrien Broner that when you come forward, when you throw a lot of punches like a Marcus Maidana or a Manny Pacquiao, you're going to give him trouble. He doesn't throw volume punches himself, so his MO is going to be survive, like he did against Pacquiao. The brother threw only two punches in that whole entire fight, and talk about, I thought I won the fight. Brother, you know damn well you ain't win that fight. But I thought that if Santiago attacked the body more, like he started to in the beginning, if he stuck with the body shots and came forward a little bit more and kept Broner on the ropes a little bit more, he would have had his shot. But then again, the referees was on some bullshit, because 117 and 110 was one of the judges' scorecard for Adrien Broner. And I don't know what the hell he was watching, but it clearly wasn't that fight, or maybe the fix was already in. And you know this is the Real Little Show, so I could say what the hell I want to say on this daggone platform. And I'm gonna tell it like it is. This is the reason why you tune into the Real Little Show, you know? And I don't know what them judges throwing that in the fight. But clearly, you know, Adrien Broner would have probably got a jaw if he got knocked out the way how it was going, you know? So, you know, his corner, Santiago corner that is, told him to get the knockout. The brother didn't get the knockout. He left it in the hands of the judges. And guess what? The judges gave the fight indeed to Adrien Broner. Now going forward, I would say this. I hope Adrien Broner gets more active, you know? I don't know about Adrien Broner, bro, but boxing sure look a hell of a lot better than being in a jail cell. You know, and I don't want Adrien Broner to get into any off the field or off the ring, outside of the ring antics. You know, I think he's too talented for that. Even though he don't always display his talent, there are always flashes with Adrien Broner that you say to yourself, bro, if only he did that a little bit more. Not even a little bit more, a lot more. If he did that a lot more, then he would be a problem. He would live up to his name, you know? And it's like Adrien Broner, these last couple of fights, yeah, his name is the problem, but he surely don't got the answer to the problem, because he always creates a problem and don't figure out the problem. But in this case, in this fight, he basically figured out the problem, I guess you could say, if that makes sense. But look, man, I just hope the guy does what he has to do. I don't think he's going to be that guy that he once was, because I just think he's not that aggressive. And then boxing, man, you gotta throw punches, man. Obviously you gotta do it smartly. Obviously it's good to, you know, be a great defender and negate the jab, but at the same time you gotta throw punches. It is what it is. But this is a guy, like I said, man, hopefully he can get it turned around. He reminds me a lot like Conor McGregor, guys that were at the prime of their career and then the fame got to them, and now, you know, they're not the same fighters. Let's call it what it is, bro. Conor McGregor is all highlights and all money, but the brother began his ass beat like he did against Dustin Poirier in that fight. Even though you could say he looked good, you know, he still lost. And that's the fight that he won early in his career. So some of these fighters, when they drop off, they're never the same. Is Adrien Broner in that category? I think he is, but he surely got the victory based on the judges' scorecard. I thought he lost the fight. But if he could rebound from this, watch the tape, and actually get more serious within boxing, I don't know if he is or not. It's hard to say with that kind of guy, because you know how fame is. You know how, you know, when the girls come around and the money flows. I'm not in that position, so I don't know. But we'll have to see going forward if Adrien Broner could, you know, rack up a couple victories here going forward. But before we get off here, let me take a sip of my water. You know, I'm getting a little thirsty here. Yes, sir. Ain't nothing like a nice glass of water, I'll tell you that. But before I depart, I want to touch on this undercard that took place before the Adrien Broner fight. We had a heavyweight championship fight, and I thought it was a valid fight. A good fight. When you talk about the undercard you have a nice heavyweight fight in the undercard of a main event. It doesn't get no better than that. Obviously, the fight didn't live up to the expectation, and I'm gonna get into that in a minute. But you had Dominic Breazeale and Otto Wallin, with Otto Wallin winning by unanimous decision. There's no controversy there. The brother dominated the fight, and these were two guys that were, you know, getting into this fight trying to make their way back to championship, world heavyweight championship contention. You know, obviously, Dominic Breazeale still waking his ass up after that knockout by Deontay Wilder. Knocked the brother out into a different state. Literally turned that brother into a daggone lizard. I'm surprised he ain't reincarnate by now. But, you know, he came into this fight and you had Otto Wallin that gave Tyson Fury all he could have given him. And these are two guys that want to get back into the picture. And Dominic Breazeale, man, look, bro, I'm going to keep it 100. This is why you tune into the Real Little Show, because I don't hold back any punches on this show either. Brother, they say you used to play quarterback, right? I know you used to play quarterback. I know The Rock say he was going to try to bring the XFL back, or he bought the XFL. But if the XFL come back, brother, yeah, I think that might be the route that you want to go to. You may want to try to play quarterback again in the XFL, because boxing is not it, brother. It's not it. I mean, the brother came into this fight, should have been motivated after a knockout like that, and it just wasn't happening. I'm talking about slow as a beetle. This brother was slow as a beetle. I mean, by the time the punches got to Otto Wallin, literally, Otto Wallin had time to think about his life and throw a dag on 10 jabs. Literally. I mean, I could have ducked the punches. We all could. All the fans watching the daggone boxing match could have ducked those punches by the time this guy threw it. He was slow. And you talking about throwing punches off balance? I mean, literally. I mean, come on. He could have got tagged. If Otto Wallin had a little bit more power. Yeah, we know he got the speed. And the speed, obviously, is what won him to fight, getting in the inside and jabbing him with the speed. If he had a little bit more power, he would have went night-night. He would have got tagged in round one like he did against Wilder, you know? And I guess you could say, well, Lil, you being a little bit harsh. He showed a little bit something in the 10th, 11th, and 12th round. Yeah, he got in there with the uppercuts, and then the uppercuts was giving Wallin trouble, and it seemed like Wallin was just trying to get out that fight, and it was like, look, we went in the fight. Let's just get out of here. Yeah, you could say that, but it's hard for me to not think about that whole body of work in that fight. The brother literally did not look in shape at all. He didn't look like the same guy at all. And this is a guy that fought Anthony Joshua and Wilder, had his opportunities to, you know, get the belt. And he got tagged in both fights. He got knocked out. This guy's a sitting duck, literally. He's easy to tag. He's slow. It played right into Wilder's hands in that fight. And it played into Otto Wallin's hands. And, you know, and like I said, if he had a little bit more power, Otto Wallin, he would have been Wallin. You know, it would have been, that would have been the case. He would have got knocked out. So, man, listen. Dominic Breazeale, in the words of Biggie, I got Biggie on my wall. Don't be mad, brother. UPS is hiring. Okay? UPS is hiring. And that's just what it is. But with Otto Wallin, I'm going to end this here. After what I saw in this fight, yeah, you know, he was impressive with the speed. But if I'm being real here, I don't think he's a match for Tyson Fury. Obviously, that first fight, he did give him a little bit trouble. But Tyson Fury, come on. He's Tyson Fury. I don't think he beats Tyson Fury. I don't think he beats AJ. I don't think he beats Wilder. You know, I don't think he beats those top-tier heavyweights in there. But I do believe he deserves a crack at it. You know, this was a match that he had to win to push himself back into the mix. And if he keeps on winning and he gets his name out there, then maybe he look compelling. But I thought he should have knocked Dominic Breazeale out. This was a fight that this guy was there for the taking. And had you tagged him, you know, you would have pushed your name up even more. Because at the end of the day, this is boxing. Politics always comes into play. When you have an opportunity to put your talents on display, you got to knock the brother into the daggone hay. And that's just what it is. Ladies and gentlemen, this is The Real Little Show, and it's time to go. I'm about to go to bed and wake up and carry on to the next day, all right? Ladies and gentlemen, like and subscribe, and once again, feel the vibe. We out.